Hello there. Have you ever dreamt of getting rich, like really rich? Then come to Brazil and become a politician. It's even better than winning the lottery. As a politician, you can steal, you can bribe, you can even commit homicide and get off scot-free. Here are just some of the 5 benefits of being a politician in Brazil. Number 1, your job is always recession-proof. While the rest of the population suffers from massive unemployment, public health cuts, education cuts, mostly because you and your friends bankrupted the country. Don't worry, your compensation is never at risk. And since Congress is the one that sets its own compensation and benefits, you and your colleagues can give yourselves a raise whenever you want, which is exactly what the Brazilian Congress did when it increased its own already bloated benefits. While at the same time, the country was shutting down public schools, public hospitals, because it allegedly didn't have any money left. Whoops. Number 2, you will live in impunity. Feel like diverting more than $10 million from a public road project into offshore bank accounts like Congressman Paulo Maluf, who is now wanted by Interpol? Or maybe of even having lobbyists make payments to your mistress, like Senate President Renan Calheiros? Or even of allegedly attempting to have one of your political rivals killed off, like current House Speaker André Moura? Even if the authorities do find out, as a politician, most of you have a legal privilege called o foro privilegiado, which means that you can only be tried by the already overburdened Supreme Court, a notoriously slow body of 11 people who have tens of thousands of new cases every year, which means that you'll most likely never be tried for a crime, walking out with your freedom in hand. Unless you really manage to screw up, like former House Speaker Eduardo Cunha, who dug his own grave by lying in court about having millions of dollars stashed in Swiss bank accounts, leading him to be expelled from Congress, thereby losing all of his legal privileges. Number 3, being a politician comes with some amazing benefits. You will get a clothing allowance, a food allowance, a housing allowance, a living stipend allowance, all paid by the hard-working taxpayers.
O estudo da organização Transparência Brasil concluiu que os parlamentares brasileiros são os mais caros do mundo. O minuto trabalhado aqui custa ao contribuinte R$ 11.545.
Por ano, cada senador não sai por menos de R$ 33 milhões. O custo anual de um deputado é de R$ 6.600.000. Os valores gastos com o Congresso causam ainda mais espanto quando comparados a países mais ricos que o Brasil. Se fizermos a média dos custos de deputados e senadores, cada parlamentar no Brasil sai por R$ 10.200.000 por ano. Na Itália, R$ 3.900.000. Na França, pouco mais de R$ 2.800.000. Na Espanha, cada parlamentar custa por ano R$ 850.000. E na vizinha Argentina, R$ 1.300.000.
Feel like spending $30,000 a month to employ a gardener and 2 archivists like Senator Fernando Collor did? Or, if you manage to make it to a high political office, like being Speaker of the House, the Brazilian taxpayer will foot the bill for your chef, 3 cooks, 3 kitchen assistants, 4 waiters, 2 housekeepers, 4 drivers, and 8 private security guards, in addition to the 16-person legislative police detail, along with a number of other employees, for a total cost of nearly $200,000 a month. You'll also have an official residence, the use of planes owned by the Brazilian Air Force, and get this, Even if you're suspended on accusations of corruption, you'll still retain most of these benefits. That's right, because you've earned it. Number four, if you don't feel like showing up for work, don't worry because you don't have to. While the average Brazilian citizen works about 221 days a year, most congressmen only show up for what amounts to less than 4 months of work. Because you don't work harder, you just work smarter. And number five, this one is a personal favorite of mine. If a law doesn't work for you, then just change it. Just like you and your colleagues in the Congress did when you ousted a sitting president for tampering with the budget, and then 2 days later, passed a law to make it legal to tamper with the budget. Gotta love it. Now that's all, my friends. Isn't it good to be a politician in Brazil? Or is it time for political reform?